Oh, what else we have here to talk about? Listen, you know what? Let's go into some trainers and no, let's go into some other club wear stuff as well. Why not do that? Let's do some clubbing stuff as well. Let's talk about that. So, in other clubbing news, I'm sure you guys are aware, or some of you guys have heard, there's a nightclub opening up at Croydon. This is on the back of my conversation about Fold, but this is interesting because this is something I've kind of spoke about previously. I'm not sure if I've, you know, if my voice is traveling across the internet airwaves and people have heard my message, but this is kind of similar to the thinking I had when it came to being able to somehow create spots or create safe spaces for people who want to go out and club and want to go out and stay out until the early hours in the morning, creating spaces where they can go and enjoy themselves, and also spaces that don't infringe on local residents, you know, general enjoyment of their area too, wherever it may be. So this news broke recently, or just a few days ago, and as reported by Resident Advisor here, London is getting a new nightclub, a new club called FaZe. The 500 capacity venue, same size as Fold, is opening up in Croydon in December. And I think I mentioned previously that when Fold opened, I was very infused about Fold being the first 24-hour nightclub, or just being a nightclub in general that opens until 6 a.m. There's not many of them. Maybe what's that place, Egg nightclub as well, closes at 5, maybe a few others. There's a few others, the speakeasies that close at 5, but an actual nightclub that closes after 3 a.m. there's not many that you can find. My idea when Fold opened was that London, the London mayor, or the London night czar, that Amy Lammy, that useless woman, hopefully that she can kind of pull her finger out and somehow drive an initiative where we have one late night spot in each area of London, north, east, south, west. We have one area that you can go to if you're a local resident, or you're somebody that's involved in a local electronic music scene, or whatever it may be, a place that you can go to and rave in peace. A place that it doesn't infringe on the local residents either. A place that's far away from all the major residential hotspots. Because I think each area in London has its equivalent of Canning Town, has an industrial, parky sort of area that you could go and set up a bespoke nightclub, have it completely insulated with soundproofing, and make sure, and of course, if it's near a station, that's going to be advantageous, but you can allow it to be kind of self-contained in that area so it doesn't bleed over into other areas of that place where basically the nightclub is located. And I thought that would work out pretty well, because then what it would do, it would inadvertently ease the foot flow and the traffic in other areas dotted around your town or city. Because I think part of the reason why Dalston went through such a fucked up moment with licensings was because they hand that license to everyone at one go, then essentially a whole wave and movement of hipsters and scenesters and people involved in the scene flooded that area all at once. And it just couldn't handle the capacity. There were just so many different people packing in different spots that were all open in different varying amounts of time, different capacities, different licensing laws. And essentially it kind of crumbled, and essentially the unintended victims were the local residents. But I think you can ease some of that pressure by allowing the people that do want to stay until 6, 7, 9, 8, 10, 9 a.m. in the morning, allowing them a spot to go to will then ease the pressure on your local bars and clubs. Because if you've noticed, most people that go out at nighttime, you have probably noticed an upsurge in people not going out at nightclubs, but getting fucked up at bars, cocktail bars, wine bars, nice restaurants, whatever it may be, right? People are kind of using those places and meeting up with friends as a way to kind of have a night out in that respect. Especially if you go to a bar in East London that has like a relatively decent DJ, you can probably get away with having your kind of quote unquote night out in like a local bar on the strip in Shoreditch High Street. You can probably do that in Dragon's Bar, because they usually have a half decent DJ, great drinks, great ambiance. It's open until about 1 a.m. station right around the corner. You can get your thing and go. But again, you can ease the traffic in a place like that by allowing people to go to a nightclub somewhere located in East Industrial Area, North, West, South, whatever it may be. And I think FaZe might be the answer to Southway, right? Especially it being in the depths of Croydon, there's only a certain group of people that are going to want to go there. But anyway, the issue is, this is the article. FaZe, a new nightclub art space in London, will open its doors next month. Croydon venue, comprised of two club night floors and a studio, has a 4 a.m. license and a 500 capacity. On Fridays and Saturdays, FaZe will run parties and with additional midweek events for live music and comedy shows. The programming schedule is still to be announced. If this is to be announced, I want to make it known here, make it my voice clear. If it's to be announced and you guys are looking for DJs, holler at your boy. I play most of the best of everything. Good disco, good house, good techno, good funk, good soul, hip hop and R&B. If you need a DJ to come and fill in your slots, to bring some people down, again, to add a bit of authenticity and a bit of ambiance and a bit of fun and a bit of carefree attitude, holler at your boy, because this is such a great idea. If we can, if Fold can survive, hopefully with this appeal that they're going to do on Friday, and we've got the additional phase, we've got two spots in London open, one at 6, one at 4, South and East London. Then we have one more maybe opening in, maybe let's say Ealing Broadway somewhere in West London. Another one maybe opening up, especially with the fact that Cause is going to close soon. Something that can kind of maybe fill in the space for Cause. That'll be super beneficial. Hopefully that happens. Anyway, the article says the following. Fate is located in the center of Croydon, within walking distance to the three railway stations. The venue is a project of Lambeth Group and the team behind the Brixton spot, the Prince of Wales. Oh, awesome. So here's the video too that kind of details some of the things going to be happening at phase. Let's quickly watch this video. So far, we haven't received the lineup, so that's TBA, but the venue itself looks fucking beautiful. I love the lights and lamps above the bar. Music and art space. I'm also encouraged that they're going to do comedy shows as well during the week. I think that's a good way to kind of, because I'm pretty sure running a club or setting up a club and making it financially, you know, successful must be such a hard job to do, especially during the week, especially during slow months. So the idea of having it be like a hub or a spot people can go to during the week and also have comedy shows and art exhibitions is going to be beneficial. Most places do that anyway because it's the easy way to make some money during the week, but it's very nice that they're kind of making it a staple right now and putting it front and center, like a new music and art space. So again, it kind of, you know, maybe kind of softens the blow of it being just a nightclub people can get fucked up in. But again, even if that is the case, it's a welcome addition. Let's carry on with the video. Oh, nice. The layout looks interesting. So essentially, you've got a bar, I think, in the middle, like an kind of island bar with a stage. Looks like on the right-hand side a little bit. Is that a stage there? Let's just look at it a little bit different because we don't really know what it looks like unless we kind of watch this video. Yeah, so we've got like a stage with amazing bits of lighting in it. So maybe the speaker boxes there. There's an entry. There's a booth to sit down in. It was fairly interesting. I'm really interested to go check out what it's going to look like. I'm definitely going to go. As per usual, I try and go to all the first nights of all these events because it's good to kind of gauge an idea as to where it kind of, you know, where it started from and kind of where it's going in the future. But yeah, it looks really cool. I like it, man. What a great idea. Again, hopefully we get more of these. It's a collaboration with, what's it, Lambeth Group and the Prince of Wales as well. So there's obviously some kind of synergy going there, some sort of communication and cooperation. Hopefully other councils see this as a way to kind of, again, inject some new life, inject some new money. Maybe, again, the possibility of also, because you have to understand that when scenes are kind of built around these kind of places and people inevitably move to those areas too, right? So they come in and they become kind of taxpaying residents after a while, because then they want to set up spots, they might want to open up a studio themselves, maybe have maybe kind of, you know, open up their own nightclub. It's only a net benefit, a net positive for everyone involved, really. So I think I would like to see more of these spots pop up, especially the collaborations with local councils. And hopefully with Fold winning this appeal, we'll have two spots in London opened and after 3 a.m. which is definitely going to be a benefit for everyone involved. So definitely check it out. Phase. It's not open just yet at the moment, opening in December. You probably could be able to find a nightclub listed on Resident Advisor to get some dates and see who's going to be playing. But no dates already kind of confirmed now at the moment. But definitely check it out if you're that way inclined. 500 capacity place, probably a bespoke sound system, right in the middle or right in the heart of a Croydon surrounded by all the three major railway stations. So no danger of anyone missing their trains and stuff. So yeah, definitely check that out if you're that way inclined. I really recommend it. I'm happy to see more places pop up.